don't care what anybody says, that theme song still rocks.
Pickled. The brain of a super genius transplanted into the body of a perfect physical specimen.
I want a man that makes my blood run cold. A man that every time he enters my crypt, it's like a stake through my dead black heart.
I can whip the upper humpy down in the lab.
Oh no, remember what happened last time?
He was battered.
I'm gonna go.
Okay.
Looking for a vision. A queen. True love.
And what exactly do you want?
Is Herman Munster in there?
The Munsters. I will fully admit to having a soft spot for this property. I remember watching the show as reruns on weekday afternoons when I was a kid. Yes, I said reruns, I'm not that old. It was always a toss-up between them and the Addams Family. Personally, I think I preferred the Addamses, but I always thought these guys had a better theme song. The thing is, there have been many attempts over the years to try and revamp the Munsters. Pun not intended, but I'll run with it. They tried in the 80s with a whole new cast, then again in the 90s, once again recasting all the roles. And not too long back, we had the rather drastic reimagining that was Mockingbird Lane, which I actually really liked. But the one thing all of those attempts had in common was they all wound up 6 feet under. Told you I was going to run with it. So it was strange, but maybe not completely unbelievable, that they were going to take another stab at the concept. But of all the people who could possibly have been linked to this project, Rob Zombie? I do not like Rob Zombie as a filmmaker. I really don't think it is a skill that he possesses. House of a Thousand Corpses did nothing for me, so I have never had any interest in seeing any of the follow-ups. And I am still livid over what he did to the Halloween franchise. How do you take a concept that simple and brilliant and fuck it up that badly? Breathe. Calm down. Remember what the therapist said. For anyone who is a fan, or for that matter even remembers the Munsters, this is a prequel to the original series. It shows how Lily and Herman met, fell in love, got married, and the events that led them to moving to 1313 Mockingbird Lane. It fits perfectly into the continuity of the original show, which I think is what the film's main problem is. See, this is not a reboot. It's not a remake, a revamp, a reimagining, or any of those other terms constantly dragged out to justify Hollywood's idea drought. It's an attempt to make an episode of the original show nearly 60 years later. That seems to be the overriding decision that influences and directs all of the creative choices involved in this film. Not only are they bringing back the characters, but it's trying to recreate the writing, the comedy style, the acting, the shooting style, the framing, the production design. The whole aesthetic is one big copy and paste from the 60s. Take Herman, played by Jeff Daniel Phillips. Everything is done to try and make him look exactly like Fred Gwynne, which would not have been easy, as Fred was, let's be polite and say, an original and distinct looking gentleman. Actually, I get the feeling that casting a new Herman Munster is like trying to cast a new Superman. Not only do you need to find an actor who can actually play the role, but there is a very particular set of physical requirements. Jeff looks the part, and he does a pretty convincing impression of Fred, but that's all it is. It's an impression, it's not at all its own character. You get the same sort of vibe from Grandpa, played here by Daniel Roebuck. He is doing his best Al Lewis. In fact, the whole thing feels like a group of day players doing a Rocky Horror-esque live show of old episodes. One thing I will give props for, though, is Sherry Moon Zombie's depiction of Lily. Sherry is the queen of nepotism actors, having only ever appeared in films directed by her husband. The only other person I can think of who plays the "my family's in show business and that's why I have a career card harder" is Harley Quinn Smith. And the less said about her, the better. Credit where credit's due, Sherry has routinely done the work though. She has never stood out as, well, it's easy to pick the director's wife in this, and she throws herself into the role of Lily Munster with 100% enthusiasm and determination. I'm not saying it's a standout role, but she commits and commits hard. This was a girl that understood the assignment. There are a few other cameos from actors playing smaller but important parts. My personal favorite was George Garcia as a hapless assistant slash minion for the mad scientist that brings Herman to life. The woman behind the beehive and the boobs of Elvira, Cassandra Peterson, plays a small part as the real estate agent that sells the Munsters their iconic home. And as much as I love Elvira, I feel Cassandra has been playing that character for so long, she really can't switch it off when she tries to play other roles. It is possible that Zombie asked for that particular performance as well, so I don't want to be too mean to her. As far as the way the film looks, whoever did the production design honestly deserves some sort of award. The sets are incredible. They perfectly match the 60s cheesy haunted horror sets from the original show, just with the volume turned up a few notches. And I don't know if they built a whole new house or just redressed the original Munster house, which is still on the back lot at Universal. In fact, watch an episode of Desperate Housewives really closely and you'll see that Terry Hatcher actually lives next door to it. But they absolutely nailed the look of the original home. Adding to this is the way the sets have been lit. It's beautiful and bizarre, with all manner of coloured lighting and smoke effects adding to the atmosphere. The same goes for the costume design. I'm pretty sure that every one of Herman's costumes was a reference to one episode or the other. What lets everything down, though, is the cinematography. It's terrible! Everything is so extraordinarily flat and ugly looking. It's that cheap digital TV look from the early 2000s midday movies. In fact, there are scenes shot around what looks like a theme park castle, and it looks like those shitty Welcome to the Park videos you sometimes see being played on screens while waiting in line at said venues. I realised at one moment there was a focus pull to try and give the scene some depth, but it just went from being flat to being blurry and flat. The movie is a slog. It's an hour and 47 minutes long. And I was looking to the door after only 45 minutes of forcing myself to sit still. I eventually made it all the way through, but I walked away several times before reaching the end. That's not to say it's all bad. I genuinely laughed at some of the jokes. And while I really cannot say I had a good time watching this film, it didn't make me want to stab myself in the brain the way Zombies Halloween did. I don't know why I'm trying so hard not to be nasty about this review. Maybe it's because, unlike most remakes and reboots we get nowadays, this wasn't some soulless attempt to just cash in on some old IP that was still sitting in the basement. There was a definite love and reverence for the source material that went into this. It's just a shame that that affection came from Rob Zombie. I really don't think he has the talent or the ability to make something exactly like he remembered it, but add something new that would entice new viewers. Unless you're insanely curious, or a hardcore Munsters fan? Let's face it, there's got to be some of you out there. I would say give this one a miss.